And in Baltimore and several other cities, Occupy protesters were joined by unions and advocacy groups. To highlight the issue of decaying infrastructure and not enough jobs, local demonstrators marched across the Howard Street Bridge. 11 News reporter Sheldon Dutez is live downtown at McKeldin Square with that part of the story. Sheldon?
Well, Rod, a lot of people associate the tents out here in McKeldin Square with the Occupy Baltimore movement. But today, folks out here met up with other grassroots organizations in Midtown to make their fight known.
Protesters here in Baltimore marched across the Howard Street Bridge, demanding to bridge the gap between the 99% and the wealthiest 1%.
All these folks here are the customers of Wall Street and the companies that Wall Street is trying to represent. And yet Wall Street is not paying attention to the needs of its customers.
John Heron identifies himself with the 99%. He says his Jesuit education at Loyola University taught him the importance of ethics and social justice. That's why he joined hundreds of other protesters to speak out against corporate greed during Baltimore's Day of Action.
I think a lot of the trading and the credit default swaps and things like that are gimmicks that really don't add value to our country.
The protest was organized by Good Jobs, Better Baltimore, but other grassroots organizations were there, as well as Occupy Baltimore and unemployed workers. Event organizers say the demands of this demonstration were similar to those in other cities.
We needed to bridge the gap between the 1% and the 99%, and we need to bring jobs back here to Baltimore City. We need to put Americans back to work.
In addition to job creation, protesters demanded that politicians invest in crumbling infrastructure, like the deplorable conditions at this teacher school.
I am fed up with rodents, rats, roaches. I'm fed up with bathrooms that smell of sewer. I'm fed up with sinks falling off the wall, cracks in the floors, holes in the ceilings. I think our kids deserve better.
The march ended peacefully, but protesters hope their demands won't fall on deaf ears.
Now, earlier this week, Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake said it's illegal for people to camp out here, but it's unclear how or when that law will be enforced. We're live tonight at McKeldin Square in Baltimore City. Sheldon Dutez, WBAL-TV 11 News.